Hi, my loves. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Jess from Bahati Life. Thank you so much for tuning in. I am so excited to talk about this topic with you guys. It is what your dreams mean and if it is important and symbolic in your life. And the answer is hell yes, it is. This is actually one of my favorite topics to talk about, and I get asked about it more than you guys know. And the reason for that is it's just something that we all pretty much experience at some point in our lives, or there is a dream that you can think of that just stood out to you that was so impactful and meaningful, and maybe you don't know why you dreamt it, what messages it was trying to bring into your life, and you can't forget it. Either it was the best dream or the worst dream, and we're gonna break it down why you had that dream and what that dream means. So let me go ahead and start with this. What is a dream essentially? Now that's a really simple, but it's also kind of complex, just like the dream itself. A dream is a series of visions or images and feelings that play out in your unconscious mind. Emphasis and put a pin in the word unconscious. Sometimes they make sense, sometimes they don't make sense, and sometimes they totally deviate from all things that could be normal. Like, it could be so abnormal. Let's say in your dream, you're in a room and then you turn to the left, you walk through a doorway, and now all of a sudden you're in an ocean. Like, dreams could be so random. You'll even find that the dream itself, that when you are watching it kind of play out, it makes sense, but when you start telling a friend or telling someone what it was that you dreamt, you're like, wait a minute, now that I'm saying this out loud, I don't even know how that happened, but it made sense to me in the dream at that time. That's what I love about dreams, is just how completely random they are. But is it random? And the answer is no, it's not random. Let me explain. So basically, the purpose of the dream is to show you what is unconsciously happening in your mind. The reason for this is for our very own survival, but more than that, if you dig a little deeper, I believe that the purpose of the dream is not just for your survival, but also to show you how to thrive. Because if you break down the dream into detail, you'll see symbols, you'll see messages, and clues to what's happening internally to help you to better understand yourself, your environment, and hopefully give you additional tools and resources to change the current status, whatever that is, to be something that helps support you and helps make your time here on Earth a little bit more enjoyable, or at least something that you can better understand. Now, let me break that down a little further for you. The mind is one of the most complex and also simple places. It's simple because if you understand how it works, you'll realize that it works with symbols and it needs the space to create, to play, to express itself. It's complex in the way that it uses those same symbols to express what's going on in the unconscious level. I hope that makes sense. Let me break that down a little further. This is something I'm actually really familiar with, because as an intuitive, an astrologer, and a tarot reader, I work with symbols all the time. My job and my purpose is to interpret the symbols that I'm receiving to help better understand the bigger picture. And my intention is to take that message and then give it to my client in a way that they can change their lives for the better. That's essentially what's happening within the dream. When you allow your brain the time and the space to express itself, which is usually when we're sleeping, it doesn't have a specific task that it is that it's focusing on or that it needs to complete. It just has creative free time play. The brain never shuts off. So at the time when you are most dormant and you're quiet and you're resting, that's when the mind has, again, that free space to play, to create, and to express itself. So it connects almost instantly with the unconscious mind and starts to reveal to you certain patterns or certain things that it wants you to observe and to see, so that you can actually see what is going on beneath the surface for you and also in your environment. The best way that it does that is by working with symbols, because the brain is always looking for symbols and it's always interpreting the symbols. We do this in ways that we are aware of, and we also do this in ways that we are completely unaware of. To really dive into that would be the longest conversation, so I'm just going to skim over that area and focus on the dream portion of this, which is why you're tuning in tonight anyways. But our brains are always trying to find these symbols, and one symbol, one thing, packs a lot of message and can pack a really complete, powerful punch. In that quiet space, the brain doesn't limit itself to this one symbol representing a limited amount of things. That one symbol that the brain chooses could be an infinite amount of things, but it's what resonates as true for you. For example, I had a client come to me recently and say, Jess, I had a dream that the person that it is that I love the most hooked up with my best friend, and then my best friend told me about it, and I told him, yo, what are you doing? You know, this person's not good for you at all. And I forgave him in that moment, but the entire process made me feel sad. And in that moment, I was like, well, you know, what's going on in your day-to-day life? And it was revealed the person that they loved the most had pretty much kind of cut them out and told them that the relationship that they were hoping for didn't really have a high chance of, you know, manifesting or becoming anything more serious than it already was. And it pretty much was a little directionless. When they woke up, that person had the heaviest feeling on their heart. And it was bad enough that in their waking life, they kind of felt the rejection of that person. But to relive it during the dream felt like the most cruel and unusual form of punishment. It's true that it does feel like cruel and unusual punishment the way that the mind works. But what it's doing and what the mind is doing is it's revealing to you your unconscious beliefs. It's revealing to you this unconscious truth that you may have accepted for yourself. So let me break down that dream for you guys as a quick example. But essentially, like I was saying, is that when you're working with a dream, it's using symbols to represent certain themes and traits and belief systems that are found within your life, within your personal life, and also your belief system. So in their waking life, this person was dealing with the idea of rejection, right? So the person that they want the most is the same thing that is then currently rejecting them in their waking life. But while the mind is at rest and while that person is sleeping, the brain is working really hard to kind of heal that unconscious truth that that person has been holding on to. So the brain chose that person as a symbol to represent the things that it is that they love the most. In this case, which is love and to be accepted for who that they are. Right? Not only has the brain found this person as love and acceptance, and that's what that person symbolizes, right? It's not just that person specifically, it's the fact that that person represents love and acceptance and approval for who they are to their core, flaws and all. That's what it is that they're striving for. That's what it is that they're ultimately seeking and hoping to gain from that person. So the mind recognizes unconsciously that that is what they are seeking in that person. So in the dream, it chooses that as a symbol to represent that exact thing. So when my client feels rejected by this person, he also feels a sense of betrayal because the one person that represents total unconditional love and acceptance of him, his best friend, has then been manipulated and taken advantage of by this one thing that is now rejecting him. So do you guys see how the brain is choosing certain people and certain things to represent unconscious truth? This is why I'm saying that the brain is so complex, but it's also so simple. In order for you to interpret your dream, you have to break down what that thing, that symbol, actually represents. And in order to do that, you have to have a healthy sense of understanding of what that person, what that thing means to you. For example, when these two people got together and they were intimate, for that person, that was the ultimate act of intimacy and the ultimate act of connection. And for the best friend and the love of their life to come together in that form, it is the ultimate act of betrayal. What I found so significant and powerful that the unconscious mind was revealing to not only to me, but also to my client, was that their reaction was not to become angry or to want revenge or anything like that, or even to cry. Their first reaction was to approach both of those people, both of those parties, with compassion and forgiveness instantly. That is the unconscious mind's way of showing them their strengths and also giving them clues to how they can heal themselves. To focus on that aspect and not these aspects of betrayal or the fact that they're not being chosen by the thing that it is that they want the most. Like I was saying, I totally understand that breaking down these symbols can be very complex and simple at the same time. Again, this is my work that it is that I do, and I love it. I've been excellent at it from I stepped out of the womb. I was just interpreting things and picking up on things and putting the pieces of the puzzle together. So I can understand how for some of you guys, looking at some aspects of your dream can really feel overwhelming and also very intimidating. One of the best things that I can recommend for anyone who wants to dive into their dreams a little further and deeper is to record all of your dreams. And I don't want you to wait to do this. As soon as you wake up, I want you to have a notepad, a pen or a paper or something, a marker, a crayon, I don't know, whatever it is that you prefer that you can have within arm's reach that you can grab and then you can write your dream in full detail. For some of you guys, maybe writing it down is not the solution for you. I know I have many clients that are using their phones to record their dreams in specific detail as soon as they wake up, and then they save them in an email or they save them in a folder on their phone or elsewhere. The only reason why I haven't done that is because I have a lot of dreams, usually almost every night or every other night, and I know for a fact that my storage would be completely filled within a week. That's why writing it down works for me, or also typing it and saving it on an online journal. But to each their own, whatever works best for you, whatever makes it so that writing it down and documenting it is easy and effortless and not a struggle. I don't want you to put pressure on yourself to understand the ins and outs of the dream. I actually want you to take off the pressure of you trying to figure out what that symbol means. Sometimes when we apply pressure and we're too intense, we're trying to decode and to decipher, we end up limiting ourselves because we're trying to find an answer and a solution so badly that we just kind of accept the first thing that comes to our mind, or we beat ourselves up because we can't figure it out. So cancel out all that pressure, cancel out all that expectation of getting it right on the first time. The goal is just to get the dream out in full detail. The things that I want you to pay attention to are, how did that dream make you feel? Paying attention to your own personal feelings is a key in any type of intuitive work, but definitely when it comes to dream work. The reason why is because when you are working with your intuitive gifts and the unconscious mind, again, the brain is working with symbols, and those symbols mean something different for you, and that symbol means something different for them, and that symbol means something different for her, and that symbol means something different for him. So what you want to do is you want to connect to how that thing, that person, that place, that situation, how did it make you feel? Because at the root of this, what the goal that we're trying to achieve and to accomplish is what's going on in the unconscious mind. In our waking lives, we could be so filled with distraction after distraction of all of the good and bad things that are going on in our day-to-day life, that's keeping us away from really decoding and understanding what's going on in our unconscious mind that impacts us on an unconscious level. But just because we don't see it, or just because we don't know that it's there, doesn't mean that it doesn't exist. And when it presents itself to us, it's your responsibility to not only capture it, but find it important enough to spend time to invest in understanding, okay, why was this something that came to me in my dream? Some common themes that we see a lot in dream symbolism are things that trigger a specific feeling. For example, we hear a lot about people who have dreams about running. Either they're running away from something or they're running towards something. The running is a symbol of a something, whatever that something is. And the way to find out what that is how did that make you feel? For some of you guys, you may feel like you're running and it's just stuck in mud, or maybe you're running and you can't see where it is that you're going. Everything feels like crusted over and you can't actually see what direction is that you're headed in. Or maybe you running feels exhilarating, or maybe you're running because something is chasing you. The act of running is a symbol of something else, and the way to find out what that thing is by asking yourself, well, shit, how did this make me feel? And then it will help you to better connect the dots between what that symbol represents in your unconscious mind and what is going on in your conscious life that you are aware of, or maybe unaware of. Let's say there's a certain person that shows up. Maybe it's Obama. Maybe Obama shows up in your dream. How did Obama make you feel when he was standing in front of you at the grocery store and he told you, here's a coupon, apply it to your order, it's gonna give you $5 off the 20 bags of toilet paper that you bought this afternoon. And you look at the coupon and you're like, thanks, Obama. So that's a really ridiculous metaphor. So let's say in your waking life, you actually don't like Obama at all. But in your unconscious mind, Obama made you feel like you were being protected. Obama made you feel like you were being provided for. He was looking out for you and he helped you to save money. So maybe in your waking life, you actually can't stand Obama, but something about him represented strength, security, stability, and he knew. And I'm wondering, by hearing that, who or what in your life is the mirror image of Obama? Because your brain chose Obama as a sign or a symbol for whatever that thing is. Whether you like him in your waking life or not, your brain chose it. Now, the next thing that I get a lot, is just, now that I know what this dream means for me, what do I do with it? And I love that question, but I also have problems with it because I feel like in our society and in our world, we are so struck with this idea that we have to do, that once I receive this information, what do I do? How do I change it? And I love that because I feel like it's very proactive. I can sense the desire to become the highest and greatest version of yourself and to change your life and your experiences for the better. But the thing is that not every dream requires action, and there's some dreams, maybe there's not a whole lot that you can do in order to change your outcome or in order to change your circumstances. The one thing that I will say that you can do is to journal it and to get out whatever it was that dream helped you to feel. Let's say this dream is so triggering to you or reminds you of some issues that you've experienced in your childhood when it comes to abandonment and being left out or being not accepted for who it is that you are. For example, that same dream that I was talking about earlier with my client who was seeking approval from this person in their personal life, and when they rejected them, how it actually impacted them to their core and how much they actually, you could actually see how willing and open they were to protect the other people that they care about the most, not only from that person, or not specifically from that person in their dream, not that there was even a connection between the love of their life and their best friend because they had never crossed paths, but you can see their ambition, you can see how they're wired to work or what their intention is to protect people, to look out for them, to forgive them, to be compassionate towards them. But at the same time, there's this need for acceptance, approval, and unconditional love that they feel that they weren't experiencing in their own life. Now, my homework that I would give to them is to break down all of the areas of their life that they can think of in this moment. The short homework would be to do in this moment, but the long homework, the lifelong homework, would be to look at all of the aspects in your life that my client felt rejected, abandoned, without love, seeking approval and not gaining it, to write down all of those things, and then to work on forgiving every single one of the people that they've crossed paths with along their life that was pushing them out and saying that you don't belong here, or I don't value you, or I don't love you. So that's something that they can do with that. But for others, there's other dreams that maybe it's not so much of what you do with it as much as it is a better understanding of, okay, this is what's going on in my life, and this is really truly bothering me. And now that I know that, I have better understanding of myself, my circumstances, and also my world. If it's in your power to change the environment or to change the circumstances or to remove yourself from something that you don't like, then by all means, take from that dream the symbols and apply it to your personal life and make positive changes. But if it's not, again, it's the unconscious mind revealing to you ways to help you to better not only survive, but to thrive. This is something that you don't have to apply it to just your dream state and dream work. You can apply it to all things because, again, like I was saying, the reason why dreams are so powerful and impactful is because when the mind is clear and the mind is resting and it doesn't have a specific task or a different task that you're allowing to distract yourself from the truth of what's going on between the lines and under the radar, it has the freedom to talk to you in the way that it is best. And one symbol holds message, like a huge powerful package, a suitcase of things that once you unpack it, that one symbol represents so many things, a big chunk of information. So you can take that and apply it to your waking life where you're looking at your relationship to certain things, your relationship with yourself. How does this person make you feel? How does your living environment make you feel? Do you feel safe there? Do you feel overwhelmed? Are you constantly running and you can't catch up? You can't escape something? Well, what is it that ultimately. You might be running from a herd of zebras, or you might be, you know, leaping through the trees to escape something or to swing into some new reality. What is it that that represents? Does that herd of zebra represent your boss? Keep piling papers on your desk? Is you swinging through the treetops, is that a symbol for you trying to navigate through the jungle of passing your college exams? What does that symbol represent for you in your life? And knowing that, what do you want to do with it? And how does it help you to better understand ultimately what it is that you're going through right now, or what it is that you've been through at some point in your life? So that is a lot of information that's kind of complex, you guys, but I love this stuff. Obviously, I do it for work, I do it for a living, and even when I'm not working, I would be doing it for a random person on the bus, or my neighbors, or my friends, or my family. They call me all the time saying, I had this dream, Jess, what does it all mean? And I can break it down for them. So I'm really curious to hear what dreams you guys have had. Some of the ones that interest me the most are not the ones that are recent, but the ones from our childhood that have so much meaning, that you could be 9 years old or 7 years old, and there's something about that dream that you can remember in specific, clear detail to this day. So I'm wondering what that dream was like for you. Is there one dream that you can think of that stands out for you? You can let me know down in the comments. I'm also interested in hearing if you're a person who memorizes your dreams, or do you forget about them? And I will say that if you're trying to get better at remembering your dreams, you have to prioritize them. Working with the unconscious mind. So the mind, your brain knows what you are saying is, or what you believe is important within your life. So you can trick others, or you can say to others that, oh yes, dream work is important to me, but your unconscious mind knows the truth. So in order for you to change your ability to remember the dream, you have to prioritize it, and you have to make it a ritual, a habit. The way to do that is to do exactly what Elizabeth is saying, is to, when you actually have a dream, no matter how far and distant and foggy the memory is, or how clear and precise the memory is, write it down immediately. This has to become a new ritual, a new habit, a new lifestyle for you, and it becomes easier to remember over time, because the unconscious mind says, okay, wait, she or he has now prioritized this, so now I'm going to make this a priority for them to be able to be in a position, in a place to actually remember it. Some things that really help when it comes to working with your dreams and remembering your dreams and to provoking dreams is to work with things like mugwort tea, working with lavender, essential oils. I personally use a prophetic dream and intention oil that I create and have created. It's available in my shop. It's called the Prophetic Dreams Intention Oil. Of course it is, because it's designed to not only help you to trigger the dreams, but also the dreams that come through, they help you to prophesy things that are going on in your life, things that are happening in your current, present, waking life, and also your unconscious mind, and also memories of the past, including past lives. All of those things get triggered and brought up to the surface. When that happens, it's your responsibility and it's your duty to write them down and remember them and to make it a priority in your life. Another tip I can give you guys when it comes to remembering your dreams and to preparing to have dreams is to disconnect from TV or your phone at least an hour and a half before you go to bed. You need to have a set routine, because you're working with the unconscious mind. The unconscious mind works with symbols and says, okay, when he gets in the shower at the end of the night and they use this oil, or there's this scent, this is helping the brain to get into a space of, okay, we're getting ready for sleep. We're entering into a space of zen. With that, it helps the brain to relax. You're disconnecting from work mode, you're disconnecting from your day-to-day life mode, and now you're entering into sleep and relaxation mode. When the body is relaxed and at ease, and when the mind is cool, calm, and collected, that's when the dreams have that creative space again to play, to express themselves, and to use all the symbols in the world to get its point across, and it will if you give it the time, the space, and the place to do so. All right, you guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I really appreciate it. Please make sure that you are subscribed to this YouTube channel, because there's plenty more videos where this came from, and if you have any questions about dream work or anything else for that matter, let me know down in the comments. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.